Hi, I'm Cassidy Rodriguez, and I'm here to talk to you about a variety of photosynthesis called CAM photosynthesis. This type of photosynthesis allows for plants that live in an arid environment to have maximum water potential, and so they don't have to lose all of their energy during the day trying to conserve water. Within hot environments, plants have to be able to adapt to their climate. So they have maximum potential and don't waste their time doing other things like trying to combat their environment. So most photosynthetic plants that use CAM photosynthesis are found in the desert. They're found in the desert because this is where there is the least water and it's the hottest during the day. So this photosynthesis usually has two different stages. One stage during the day and one stage during the night. During the nighttime, this is when the plant uses something called its stomata that are pores within the plant leaves. And they have the ability to open and close their stomata, which is where a lot of evaporation of water from leaves go out into the environment. When the stomata opens up during the night, it takes in all the CO2 it can and stores it in different types of ways inside of the plant. During the daytime, this is when the most photosynthetic part of the plant, when the real photosynthesis happens. Using the stored CO2, it breaks it down into its compounds and is able to use the intense light during the day and go through its photosynthetic process using the stored CO2, closing its stomata, reducing the majority of the evapotranspiration that would happen to a normal plant using something called C3 photosynthesis during the daytime. So, the most important aspect of this is that CAM photosynthetic plants have very, very high water potential, and they do not allow water to come in or out through their leaves. So when the stomata opens during the nighttime, in the desert, this is the majority of the time when it rains. So with it able to take in the water during the nighttime and take in the CO2 at the night, it is saving all the energy that it needs to for the photosynthesis during the hottest parts of the day when the stomata is closed and the water is not able to go out. They discovered this, or first suspected it, in 1804. And they were just thinking about how plants would have to have the ability to change their water potential for storage and conservation during the day and at the nighttime. And in 1915 there was further study about it when they knew more about cells and how plants operated, and they were realizing that it was opening and closing its stomata during the day and the night. But in 1945, the name crassulation acid metabolization, CAM photosynthesis, was named because this is where it stored all of its carbon during the night. And in the 50s, they did a study of seeing how much CO2 is taken in by putting it in a vacuum glass container and only allowing some chemicals to flow during different types of the day when there is light and when there is not light. And it showed that all the CO2 was being taken in at night in very, very high quantities. And this is why the plant is able to survive in very, very harsh climates. And most of these plants are usually cacti or succulent plants. And though they don't live in Minnesota, you still have the ability to have them inside of your house and enjoy the CAM photosynthetic properties for yourself.